Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show. Now, feel free to get in touch with us. This show airs every Thursdays at 10 p.m. here on Urban TV. We also stream live, by the way, on our socials. So feel free to watch from wherever and whenever you can. And there is definitely a repeat on Saturdays at 8 a.m. So if you miss the main show, no worries. We got you covered. You can still get this main show or a repeat of it and still learn. Knowledge is power, they say. Yep. Let's talk how to make money this week. And Lalo International Cleaning Company is thriving on consistency, hard work, and desire to be better. I keep saying, if you're a business person and you're starting out, the first question is, what is that thing that you want to ride on for you to be successful? If your clients are thinking about you as a provider or a service provider, yes, what are some of the things they talk about that will make you stand out? Now, we did visit Lalo down in Chanja, a city suburb, and despite having a number of employees, one, he is struggling with some of them that cannot just live within their means. They want money even before they work. But the other challenge is he has actually more work than he can handle at the moment. However, what's interesting, at the end of this show, the good news is he has some jobs. So if you want some, you could get in touch. Okay, let's first run you through the show and that particular interview with Lalo, and then we should get back after this.
Hello, Latigo Lauren Norris is my name. CEO, Lalo International Ghana Limited, and we are a service providing company that deals in services like fumigation, cleaning services, rodent and pest control, and compound maintenance. We basically started way back in 2018. So right now we can say that we're gladly into the market. That's about 5 years from now. And we've been into this industry for quite some time. And we think, or we ought to think, that we do have all that it takes to provide the service to the general public. What inspired me most of the times is that, you know, growing up, I always wanted to be a boss. But being a boss, I also always wanted to be a leader. Secondly, I always wanted to have so many people working under me, seeing myself helping out others. Like, one guy that always inspired me is Sudhir Luparelia. Because when you look at him, he has what we call a conglomerate company. So these are places where you find that he has over 200 human ware under him. So they help him make the money. So this helped me to start early and coming up to do with a service which never dies. Because being a service provider means that whoever you work upon today, after a certain time, you're going to be recalled to do the same work that you've done, unlike any other business. So that's why I chose to choose a service providing company like a cleaning service, because basically every home needs a clean environment and there's no way you can dodge my service. One thing I must tell you, whoever is watching us, is that in any business, there's what we call consistency. So consistency is key. We are facing a number of problems that the youths normally want to start up businesses and companies, but what challenges them is that they do lose the consistency and they also lose the patience. So initially what has to happen is that when you when you start up, you have to be consistent and patient at the same time. So in this, what I mean, you see, you find out someone has started a business, for example, you go in and say, today I'm going to deal with plates, for example, plastic plates. So as you're learning about the problems that you face dealing with the plastic plates, before you know it, you feel like it's not really giving you enough. So you drop that one and move into another business. So mind you, you're also going to learn once again a new business that you've also initiated and forgetting about the one you started with. So this keeps us in that low court of having no money, of having no businesses, thus casting our own country that there's no nothing like money in this country. So the main key is consistency and patience. So that's why you see I've moved around for the last 5 years in this same company, and at least I'm trying to now reap something out of it. When we had started in 2018, 2 years down the road, this is when we were struck by the pandemic, that is the COVID-19, which actually saw so many businesses closing down. and also others almost ruling out of the market completely. But COVID came in and it was a blessing in disguise for us, I should say, because for us, we were considered to be under those companies that were not supposed to close down. So when it came to fumigation, disinfection of different companies, remember they had to also quit certain companies to continue working. So for us, it was some of those companies that we were chosen that we continued working. So offices really came to us. We always had to go and do the disinfections. We had to do fumigations and all that. So COVID-19, instead of breaking us loose, instead it strengthened us, because this is now showed us the potential that anytime, anyhow, your blessing can come in anytime if you're consistent and also being patient. So being in the digital era, that once you want something and you really have the zeal to do it, I'm sure you have to find knowledge. So knowledge and wisdom, those are two different things. But you to do something and it succeeds, you must have the two combined. So I had to look for knowledge. Knowledge in these books, it's out there on YouTube, it's out there on Google. So I had to go out and learn about a few things on how to deal with different things. Because for example, under the sector of fumigation, when we go to the fumigation sector, we have to first of all look at the homestead. What surroundings are we having? Are we having babies there? How many grown-ups do we have? So when we come into the chemicals that we are supposed to use, they must be human friendly. If it is animals, they must be animal friendly. So all this research, I had to sit down on my own and did my own research and acquitted, and I also ensure that it is really on key and doesn't disappoint. So I assure you that all those that I've worked upon, at least I'm living a very good life up there. Right, one, we also look at what we call financial discipline. This is key when you're trying to do or have a business and managing human wealth. Now, financial discipline here comes in that at our age, we have a challenge, or we should say it is kind of a test, that once you try to move out there and get a little penny, you feel you have a million shillings on you, you can make it in a week. We get some, actually our ego overrides the pride. So this sees us making a lot of mistakes. But for me, what I did is to learn about what we call financial discipline. Now, you do not spend what you cannot actually earn in the next 1 month. So what we did is that to ensure that we create a funnel of receiving, and then the output had to be so much limited. Now in this, apart from the costs, I had to ensure that financial discipline is key, and expenditures that are unnecessary, we had to take them out. This is what has kept us in the business. I will give you an example. I have someone whom I inspired. They saw me move and started, and actually they met me physically. I told them how to start about the business, because I'm not a selfish person. I love seeing any other person grow and making things happen. But this particular person, when they got 1, 2, 3 deals in a day, they thought they had made it all. Remember that our company or our business that we're dealing with is quite expensive in running. But what we're given in return after performing a task is not so much like people see it out there. But what makes us do them or make the money is that if we're having multiple work in a day or in a month. So for them, once you got one kind of contract and they got excited, started spending, you're always there on Twitter, posing around, going to the biggest restaurants and hotels, that is what breaks us, the youth, so much. In fact, those who first of all break down and stand up, they never lose the discipline. So the next key should be financial discipline. One thing that I had to make use of, I did research. I had to go through the URSB, and we also had to go through the population, actually the census. We got to know about that our population grows so fast. Actually, it's changed, like we are chasing the Nigerians. Now, when you look at our population way back, we were at one moment 32 million. So right now we are talking about knocking the 50 million mark of people within the country. So meaning that when it comes to the sector of service providing, as far as cleaning services are concerned, the market is still too big and still a virgin market. Meaning that whoever is upcoming, we still say that the sky is so wide for anybody to keep spreading their wings without each touching any other. So in this, I look at all this as my clientele base, that everybody that is coming up with a growing population, we cannot satisfy the market as for now. So the market is overwhelming, it's too big, we can't satisfy it, and we are always here. And like any business, any company, any businessman, definitely where there's something good, there's something bad always. Now for me, our main key that disturbs us is the workers, is number one. The fact that we are dealing with youths, I have also been able to try and employ as so many as it that I can, because right about now, at least I have a minimum of about 100 people working with me. Those are youths below 30, 35 and downwards, but above 18, to really see that they take something into their pockets at the end of the day. But what the challenge comes in that these people are having so much expectation that they cannot even afford to meet. So before them searching for a job, they call it a karimu. I need a karimu. But when the karimu comes in and they start working or they got it, the karimu becomes ogurimu. So they start taking things for granted. They forget where they've come from. So that's why you see that we, the cleaning companies, keep on switching and changing workers every day. We also have those others who come with different intentions. For example, you can see where we are right now, that you find a site that has so many lapsed things and small things. So some of these workers are picky, so they keep on taking small things. Now in this, for us, we try so much to instill fear in them and also teach them on how to deal with the different kind of people that we live in. Then maybe secondly, as a challenge, would be that we are not normally recognized by the government, all right? So when we look around, it is you who has to first of all try so much to see that you are out there. Now when you make it up there, that's when the government comes in. But in this, if they are trying to fight, for example, Operation Wealth Creation, they should look out for us who have already started. Because now I remember NRM has a key point where they're saying that they're trying to fight unemployment under the youths. So let them look out for us who are already employing the youths. They look out for us and we show them how we can do it. Because on a cleaning site, for example, if I show this apartment here and cleaning it and doing it in a day, minimum I will need about 30 workers. Now each of the workers has to take something home. But now if we are not also empowered, definitely that means that another number of youths don't be unemployed.
So as you spend your time out there arguing about who is scoring more or which team is better, there's something you need to learn. There are guys that are making things happen. Some guys are actually employing others, and what makes them angry is when people say that there are no jobs in the country. For them, they're saying people need to get good work ethic and they will be successful. Lalo International is a cleaning company that has been around for about 5 years, and the CEO says they are making headways, okay? The lesson from him is, if you know what you're doing, if you stay consistent on that, if you offer what your client expects of you, then you will get more clients. And what's more important is advertising using the socials. So if you've watched this and one, you want to be employed, well, you could reach us here. We can help link you up, because like I keep saying, this show must create an impact either way, whether you watch it or you get to work with someone after watching it, good stuff. But for the guys out there, good work ethic will help you retain your customers. Feedback, very vital. That is how to make money this week. Now, let's talk a personal finance tips for this week. And week two of the four-part series of how you can get into 2023 with your finances sorted. This week, Stephen talks to us about not spending everything you earn. Quite challenging, just how you can't spend what you earn. Let's give you the tips now, personal finance for this week.
Not spending everything you earn. You know, one thing that many of us forget is that when we are working or doing business and we are earning, we're in a time of harvest. When we are earning, we are harvesting, yeah? So we do not know that winter will come. We do not know that a time will come when there is no harvesting, yeah? And that takes me back to how you asked this. You asked it. The COVID period, 2020, and for some people up to maybe end of 2021, by the time COVID came, many people had their businesses, they were sure that they were stable, they had stable income, you know, I'm not working for anyone, I'm self-employed. Other people would say, I'm working in a big company, I'm okay, and all those things. But then things did strike them without notice. You know, the company says all of you should work from home remotely. Now, some people did not know how to use computers for work, or how to use it efficiently for work, or how to use it alone without an IT officer behind their back supporting them every time they need to attach a file. You know? So at that point, they failed. And what would the company do? It laid them off. Others had their businesses that were running well. They knew everything about their business. But then the president came and said, 14 days lockdown, then another 30, then another 14, like that, you couldn't do anything about it. Your business was locked up for, you would say, no reason, like you did nothing wrong, okay? So why you don't have to spend everything that you earn is so that you have something spared, you have something put aside for that dark day when it comes, because you never know when that day will come. When the Bible talks about gathering in summer and not being asleep during harvest, it means exactly that. And again, we've had the wise words said that times and seasons will always be there. So there is a time and a season. You're not going to be earning so much all the time. So you got to make sure that you prepare for that time and for that season that you do not really know about. Now, after you have spared some of the money, the question is, what do you do with it? And we've seen many people make mistakes. There's a book also that gives more detail about this. It's a book by a man called Clason, and it's called Richest Man in Babylon. One of the nice subtopics in that book is that do not eat the children of your savings. So as you put aside money, don't say, I've been saving from January, now it is December, let me eat what I have saved. Which is what majority of the people do. That's why January comes and it is actually a January for us to be worried. Because what we saved from the beginning of the year, we ate it at the end of the year. So a new year starts and then we start by struggling, yeah? So what's supposed to happen, and what I learned also from that book, is that you are not supposed to break that savings box with the purpose of eating your savings, unless calamity has come. A pandemic has fallen, and then there's a lockdown, and your income sources have been tied up, then you can go and you pick some money from there. If not that, what you got to do with your savings is to invest it. And what you get out of that investment, again, invest it. Then it is from there that you can start buying clothes. You can start buying, doing the parties. You can start doing all those things. You know, nowadays in our time, we have lots of pressures. You grew up all your years. You didn't have maybe any birthdays. But now you've got to a point that you earn maybe 1 million a month. And you, because your daughter has a birthday, the money you had put aside was 100,000, 10% of the 1 million. But, I mean, you can't resist that pressure. You got to do something. So you get the 100,000 birthday party for your daughter. But, I mean, you got to understand what you can afford. Yeah? You got to understand what you can afford. Yeah, so that basically is it. Don't spend everything that you earn, and do not eat your savings. Unless you must eat your savings.
So if you cannot spend within your means, it means you spend everything that you have. But Stephen is saying it's important for you not to spend everything you earn. It doesn't matter how much you earn. Even if you have multiple jobs and you're making as much, it's only important that you put some money on the side. We're simply saying, not spending everything that you earn means save some, okay? And then if you can reinvest, it's good. And then spend on what you deem relevant. Okay, let's talk Forex. Mm-hmm. And the shilling held steady on flows from Treasury bill auction midweek. Now, traders said both demand and supply remained subdued in the early weeks days a session. The unit traded at about 3675 and 3685 levels all day. Here now is that comprehensive report on Forex and the money market. So you have the updates from the Forex and stock. You can now see what you need to do with your dollars. If you have some, do you need to change them or keep them where they are for a while as you wait for the rates to improve? Good stuff. So a recent meeting at the UAE summit did see some business guys tag along with the president, which is a good stuff because look, during the summit in the US, US-Africa Summit 2022, most of the guys that were with the president were actually politicians, MPs and ministers. Some of them might not be as good in business deal cuttings as the business people themselves. So we can hope that such can continue and more people, more business people can walk along with the president to these major deals. And somehow this triggers down to the final guys, the people, you and me down here in the country. That's it for this week. Thank you so much for making time. Feel free to get in touch with us. We'll be more than glad to respond. Lots of programming coming up on Urban TV, so don't go anywhere. It's a good night, I think. Yes, good night. And I'll not get tired of saying this. Happy New Year. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.